वेलकम टू ब्रहन मुंबई म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन कैंपेन। मायसेल्फ रविंद्र पवार फ्रॉम मुलुंड कैंप म्युनिसिपल इंग्लिश यूपीएस स्कूल। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग टुडेज टॉपिक आई विल शो यू सम इंटरेस्टिंग पिक्चर्स। ओके, यू हैव टू ऑब्जर्व दिस पिक्चर्स केयरफुली and raise your hand to answers. Okay, so let's start today's topic. Students, welcome again. BMC Edu Standard 6 YouTube channel. Today we are going to learn important English grammar topic. Before that, you have to observe these pictures. Okay. Now there is one question given here. You have to observe the pictures one by one and give me answers. Okay, so raise your hand and give me answer. Where is the dog in the first picture? Can you see?
The red color dog is under the box.
Okay, in the first picture, but very good. In the fourth picture, the dog is under the box. So but where is the dog in the first picture? You can see in the red box. What is the position of the dog in the first picture? What is the position of dog? If you know the answer, raise your hands.
First pair dog.
Okay. First the dog in the box. Yes or no? Dog is in the box. And in the second picture, who will tell where is the dog?
Up on the box.
On the box. Very good. Very good. In the third picture, can you saw where is the dog?
In the third picture, the behind the box.
Very good. The dog is behind the dog. Excellent answer. Or in the fourth picture, we already learned the dog is under the box. In the fifth picture, can you say where is the dog? Fifth picture. Look at the fifth picture. The purple color box is there.
In outside.
Outside. Okay. Or in front of the box. You can see the dog is in front of the box.
Okay. Front of the box.
Very good. And in the sixth picture, who will tell? So let me tell. In the sixth picture, the dog is beside the green box. Yes or no?
The dog.
Seventh picture. Where is the dog? Who will tell? Tell the answer. Where is the dog in the seventh picture? Picture is given.
The dog is beside the box.
In the seventh picture, beta. Okay. Okay. Good try. Let me tell you. The dog is between the boxes. Yes or no? In the seventh picture. And in the last picture, you can see there are the four boxes, and the dog is among the. Yes or no? So
yes,
you can see, or you answer the questions. Now observe the slide and tell me the words that given in the red colors. Which are the words given in the red color? The words given in the red color. You have to only read these words. If you want to read, raise your hand first and then give the answer.
The red one in, on, behind, under, in front of, beside, between, among.
Among, very good. Excellent, excellent. So here you can see the words given in the red color. If you remove these words, for example, we take the first example. The dog is the box. If we not
the dog is the box. The dog is the box.
So if we remove these words, we can't say or we can't relate both the parts of the sentence. The dog is or the box. Yes or no? In the all sentences. So it means that when we use these words, it links or it gives the relation between the two parts of the or the other sentence and other noun, pronoun or some other words given in the sentence. For example, if we remove on, behind, under, the sentence is not complete and there is we can't understood the what is the relation between the dog is and the box. Yes or no? So these words use us the information or they shows the relation between the noun or pronoun or some other words in the sentence. Okay, so these words, some examples are here. You can see in, on, behind, under. So these words use the relation between noun and pronoun and also some other words came in the sentences. So can you say what do you call this type of words? Can you say what do you call this type of words?
Preposition.
Prepositions. Very good. Very good. So, nice answer. So, the words, for example, given here, which gives the relation between noun and pronoun, or those some other words given in the sentence, we call these words prepositions. So, students, today we are going to learn important topic that is preposition. So some other examples are given here. You can see the position of the apple here. In the first picture, apple is placed on the box. In the second, apple is in the box. In the third, the apple is beside the box. Next, apple is in front of the box, apple is behind the box, apple is between the boxes, apple is under the box, last apple is around the box. So it means that it shows the relation between the two things, for box and the apple. So these words we call the preposition. So let's start the today's topic, preposition. It is an important topic of the grammar. It is the one part, one of the parts of speech. Okay, so today we are going to learn the objectives of the today's lesson is, first, what is preposition? We have to know that what is preposition. The second, the types of preposition. There are different types of prepositions. Apart from that, we will learn some types. Okay, the third is rules of use of preposition. So there are a lot of prepositions we use. There is some rules of using the prepositions according to their indication in the sentence. And last, there are we are going to learn some examples of preposition. So let's see one by one. So what is preposition? So a preposition is a word that shows the relation between a noun and pronoun and some other words in a sentence. Okay, so this is the definition of preposition. That preposition means what? The word that shows the relation. Okay, the relation between what? The noun and pronoun comes in the sentence and some other words. At starting, we saw some examples. that in on. They give the relation between the box and the dog, the box and the apple. Yes or no? So the words that shows the relation between noun and pronoun and some other words in a sentence, we call them preposition. One important thing about preposition is that a preposition comes before a noun or pronoun. If we observe the previous examples, we can see that there the preposition comes before a noun or pronoun. That's why it is called the preposition. Pre means before, and position means what is the place. Okay, that is why we call it prepositions. Okay, it comes before noun and pronoun. Okay, we will see some examples of prepositions here. Read the words given here. Students, read the words given here in that red color or in the which are given in the
on, in, above, on, at, in, around, up, into.
Into. Excellent. Excellent, beta. So here some words are given. Sentences are given. We can see the book is on the table. There is some milk in the fridge. The sun is above the cloud. Christmas is on December 25th. I will meet you at 12 p.m. I was born in 1982. The horse runs around the track all morning. Jack went up the hill. Sachin went into the room. The, all these words, on, in, above, on, at, in, around, up, into, all these words, if you observe carefully, it gives the relation between the two different parts of the sentence. For the book is the table, milk and the fridge, a sun and the cloud, Christmas and the date, okay, date of when the Christmas is came. I and you, here add use the relation between both pronouns. I and year, what is the birth year? Okay, here the horse and the track, okay, Jack and the hill. So in this way, these words give the relation between the noun and pronouns, and some other words came in the sentences. So that is the some examples of prepositions. Now let's proceed, students. According to the use of the prepositions, the prepositions are classified into three types according to what they indicate or show in the sentence and their use in the sentence, including place, time and direction. Okay, if we saw the previous examples here, we can see that in the some examples we can understand the place with the help of the preposition. In the some, in fourth, fifth, sixth example, we can understand the time, okay, time of the when the thing is going on. And in the third, we can see that there is a direction or movement. We can, for example, Sachin went into the room. So here is the, what is the movement or direction given here? The Sachin went into the room. So depend on this, what the preposition indicate, the prepositions are classified into three types. So we will see one by one. Okay, so we will see the three types of prepositions. The first is prepositions of place. The second is preposition of time. The third is preposition of direction. So these are the three types of prepositions. We will see one by one. Here are some commonly used prepositions list are given. Look at the screen. There are some examples given here that we use commonly in our day-to-day speech. Okay, location or place. The preposition that shows the location or place. The examples are above, behind, below, beside, between, by, in, inside, near, on, over, through. All these are the prepositions that shows the place, okay, or location. The second is some examples of the time prepositions are given here. That is after, before, by, during, from, on, past, since, through, to, until, upon. Okay, all these are the examples that shows us the time. Okay, and in the third, there is a prepositions of movement or direction. So some examples are given here: against, along, down, from, into, of, on to, out of, forward, toward, up, upon. So these are the some examples. There are a lot of examples. Some examples we took here. Okay. So we will see the one by one the use and the definition and the examples of the types of preposition. The first is the preposition of place. So place, you all know that the place means what we understood, where the something is. Okay. So what is the preposition of place? So it shows where someone or something is. Okay. What is the position? What is the position of noun, pronoun or words given in the sentence? And also it shows the position of the noun or pronoun. Okay. If any sentence is there, in that sentence, what is the position of noun or pronoun? The word shows us, that word we call preposition of place. Some examples of the preposition of place are given here. You can see here examples like at, in, on, above, below, under, between, among, before, behind, against, etc. All these are the examples of preposition of place. We can see here, students, observe these slides carefully. You can see here the position of the ball against the cube. Okay, one cube is there and ball is there. So any one of you read the one by one in the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Observe the position also and read the words given below. Raise your hand if you want to read. Hello.
Behind, in front of, next to, between, near, above, below, in, on.
Very nice. So you can see the position also. So behind, so here ball is, where is the ball? Behind the cube. The ball is in front of the cube, next to the cube, between the cubes, near the cube, above the cube. Here you can see the difference. Above, there is some space between the cube and ball is given. Next, below the cube, in the cube, or on the. Here you can see the difference in the on and above also. Okay. So, on means on the surface. Okay. And above means certain space between two things. Okay. You can see here. So, we will see the some rules of some prepositions and that we use commonly here. So you can see here three prepositions are given. Which are the three prepositions are given here? Given in the red and in the capital letters. Which are those?
On.
Next. In. and the third is at. Okay. So there are some rules of the use of preposition, students. We have to know these rules so we can use the preposition in the sentence properly. Okay. So if you know the rules, our confusions, we don't have any confusions while using the prepositions in the sentences. So they are commonly used prepositions here, on, in, at. So when the on is used, so on is used when referring to something with a surface. Okay. We saw in the example that there, we can see that in the last picture, the ball is on the cube. Okay. The ball is on the cube, the surface. They shows the surface. Okay. So on is used referring something with the surface. Okay. For example, given here, the book is on the table. So you can see, where is the book? The book is kept on the table. Okay. There is no space between the book and the table. The book is kept on the table. And the second example given here, the images are on the page. Images are on the page, not there is some distance between the page and images. Images are on the page. In this way, if you have to show or refer the surface, anything with the surface, we have to use the preposition on. Okay. The next is, where should we use the in? So in is used when referring to something that is inside or within confined boundaries. Okay. If the in preposition comes in the sentence, and when it shows the any thing or refers something, it means it inside or within the confined boundaries. Matlab, for example, the things that have the boundaries, close boundaries. Okay, if we show the place of the anything in the place that has the closed boundaries, okay, closed surface. Even it can be country, state, district also. Okay, so some examples also here. The girls play in the garden. Now you can see where is where the girls are playing. The girls play in the garden. So we can see the garden has also the boundary. Okay, a small garden, big garden, but garden has the boundaries, limitation of boundaries. Okay. The milk is in the fridge. In the second example, you can see where is the milk? The milk is in the fridge. Okay. Here we can say that the milk is inside the fridge and girls are playing inside the garden. Okay. And the third is at. So when do we use the at? So at is used when referring to something at a specific point. When if you have to refer specific point, okay, at that time you have to use the preposition of place, that is at. For example, we will meet at the airport. Here specific point given here, airport. So where they will meet? So they will meet at the airport. Okay, at the airport. Okay, the specific point is given here, airport. And second, he stood at the bus stop. So if you ask the question where he stood, so we can give the specific point, which is the specific point given here, so at the bus stop. Okay, here airport, bus stop mentions the or refers the specific point. So in this way we can use the preposition, that is on, in, at. Okay. So let's proceed, students. The next is the preposition of time. The next types of preposition is preposition of time. When the time word comes in our mind, we can say that it gives the when an event happens or happen. Okay, when the time, actual time of the event or something is happen. Okay, the words that shows the time called preposition of time. Some examples are given here also: at, on, for, since, before, after, by, during, from, etc. So all these are the examples that shows the preposition of time. We will see some examples and the use rules of using some preposition of time. Here are some examples given here, students. For example, when do we use the in, on, at to refer the time? In the morning, for example, I always go to the walk in the morning. I always take a coffee in the afternoon. Sun sets in the evening. On Monday, on Wednesday, on Sunday. If you refer the time with the days, you have to use the on. After that, if you want to give the specific time, so for example, at 8:30 a.m., at 12 o'clock, at 6 p.m. So in this way, there is some difference in these three prepositions while using in the sentence. Okay, so we will see some rules. Okay, so use of some prepositions of time. Here are some prepositions are given: on, at, in. I took here only these were because these are commons. Okay, the first is on. So on is used as an indicator for days, dates, specific holidays. Okay, so if you want to indicate days, dates, specific holidays at that time, you can use the preposition on. With the help of example, you can clear the concept. We go to school on Monday, but not on Sunday. Okay, we go to school, but when? On Monday, not on Sunday. So here we indicate the days, Monday, Sunday, in this way. The second example is my birthday is on 10th October. Here on is came and it gives the relation between the birthday and the date of birthday. So when the birthday is came, so 10th October. Here date also given and month also given. So in this way, we have to use the on when we have to indicate the days, dates or specific holidays. Okay. The second is at. So when do we use the at? So at is used to point out specific time. Okay. When we saw the preposition of place at there, we saw that it is used to specific point. And when we have to show the time, specific time, we should use the preposition at. With the following example, you can clear the how we have to use the at. So I will meet you at 12 p.m. Okay. So at what time he will meet him? So at 12 p.m. Specific time is given here. He not said in on Monday, on Thursday, on March. Specific time of 12 p.m. given here. So when we have to point out specific time, you have to use the preposition of time, that is at. The bus will stop here at 6:30 p.m. Here also given the specific time, 6:30 p.m. 6:30 ka time pe bus waha pe rukta hai. Okay, so in this way, when we have to refer or point out specific time, we have to use the preposition at. And the third is preposition of time is in. So in is used for unspecific time during day, month, year and season. Here students, see the difference of on, at, in. Here on means what to indicate day, date, specific holidays. Okay, and at is for only point out specific time. And here in, when we use the in, unspecific time, not the correct time is given, and the time is going during. Okay, the day, month, year, season. For example, the new semester will start in November. Okay. She always reads the newspaper in the morning. Here, some first in the info, specific unspecific time given in the November. They not sure the date in the November when the new semester will start in the 1st November or 2nd November or 3rd November. Only refer the month. Okay. And in the second, Here also, she always reads the newspaper in the morning. We are not given the specific time at 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock, 7 o'clock. So, she always reads the newspaper in the morning. So, in this way, you can use these prepositions on, at, in the sentences. So, the third and the last type of preposition is preposition of direction. So, direction or movement. So, it shows the direction in which someone or something comes or goes. Here we can say the direction or movement. What is the movement or direction is going on? The word that shows these things in the sentence we call preposition of direction. Some examples are given here. You can observe the examples here. Two commonly used preposition of direction. Towards, for, along, across, up, down, into, against. All these words are familiar with us because we use commonly in our speeches. Yes or no? So these words we call the preposition of direction. Let's see the some examples here. You can see here there is some movement in the ball. Okay. Movement is going on. In the first, the ball is going down the stairs. In the second, the ball is going up the stairs. In the third, the ball throws out of the box. Ball is going into the box. The arrow is showing that ball is going towards the box. Next one, the ball is going away from the box. Okay. Or next means the ball is past the box and the ball is going over the box. So here, the movement of the ball is shown. Okay. So when the preposition that shows the movement or direction in the sentence, that prepositions we call the preposition of movement. Let's see the some rules of commonly used preposition of directions. The first is to. So to, it is used to highlight that there is a movement towards a specific destination. If you want to move or if anyone is moving to specific destination from one place to another place, at that time we have to use the preposition to. Examples clears you how it is. So the example is they went to their village in vacation. So here destination given the village. Okay, where they went to the their village. Okay, here specific destination given, which is destination the village. They went, but where? At the to their village. And in the second example, he went to America for higher education. Okay. Where he went? So he went to America. What is the destination? The destination is America. Okay. So in this way, to show the movement towards a specific destination, we have to use the preposition to. The second is in. It refers to entering or looking inside something. What the word into refers, preposition into refers, entering or looking. The action is going on. Okay, looking, ing is there. So action is going on. What action is going on? The action of going inside or looking inside, not outside. Okay, when something is entering or looking inside, that at that time we use the preposition into. Example is there. Rahul went into the room. Where the Rahul is entering, the Rahul went into the room. They stare into the darkness. Where going to they stare? They stare into the darkness. Here the action is going on. The relation between the staring and the darkness, the relation between the Rahul, where the Rahul went, and the room, the words into shows their relation. And the action is going inside something. So that's at that time we have to use the preposition into. The next some examples common are up, over, down, around. All indicates the direction of movement. The direction. If any action is going on, it gives the information about the action of noun or pronoun. So Jack went up the hill. So where is the Jack went up the hill? The direction is up. Okay. And the second, he jumped over the wall. He jumped, but where? Over the wall. So in this way, we can use these prepositions. Okay. So students, today we learn some important points, that is preposition. What is preposition? Definition of it. Three types of preposition. So let's recap in short what we learned today. Okay. So first of all, we learn or we see that saw that a preposition combines with a noun or pronoun to show location, time, and direction. Okay. And there are three types of prepositions, including time preposition, place preposition, and direction preposition. The time prepositions are those indicating time, such as in, on, before, after, etc. The second type we saw, place of preposition, are those indicating position, such as on, in, between, in front of, beside, etc. And the third we saw, the types of preposition, that direction of, direction prepositions are those indicating direction or movement, such as up, down, into, through, etc. So students, here we saw the some examples. There are a lot of examples. We just go through the basic prepositions that we use. Okay. If you goes in the higher standards, the difficulty level or the use of different prepositions, you can see when they are used. Okay. So here we only saw the basic things of the prepositions and some basic and commonly used prepositions. Okay. So I hope you understood the topic very well. So it's time to assignment. Complete the assignment. One question is in front of you here. Use the following prepositions in your own sentences. You have to make the sentences with the help of these prepositions, that is on, in, at, up, under, into, to. Only this one, okay? Not the others, okay? So this is your assignment. So students, if you have any doubt, so you can ask me now. If you have any doubts regarding prepositions, the content today we learn. Anyone, if you have any doubt, students, you can ask me freely. Raise your hand first. Okay, no doubts.
No doubt, sir.
Okay, so thank you, students, to join this session. So, and lastly, I will say you be safe, be happy, have a nice day, and subscribe for more videos to our YouTube channel, that is BMC Edu English Standard 6. Okay, for more information of other subjects and other topics, you have to like, share, or subscribe our YouTube channel, that is BMC Edu English Standard 6. Okay, thank you very much.